Are you struggling to manage the complexity of your cloud native setup? Have you heard that building an internal developer platform could be the solution to your pain, but you're not really sure how to get started? Well, you're not alone. Hi, I'm Luca from the Platform Engineering Community. In this video, we're going to dive into platform as a product and how platform teams can use this approach to build better self-service capabilities for application developers and broadly their engineering organization. All right, so first of all, what is platform engineering? Well, platform engineering is the discipline of designing workflows and golden paths for developers so that they can self-serve the tech and tools they need to run their apps and services without having to depend on their operation colleagues. The sum of these golden paths is commonly referred to as an internal developer platform, or IDP for short. The IDP is the product that is built by the platform engineering team and shipped to the rest of the org as a product. So what do we mean by platform as a product? Platform as a product means building, extending, and maintaining your internal developer platform using product management principles and best practices. The idea was actually first brought up in ThoughtWorks Technology Radar in 2017, and it was then popularized among a broader audience thanks to the book Team Topologies by Manuel Pais and Matthew Skelton. So in this context, platform as a product means building a platform that is customer-focused with developers as the primary customers of the platform team. Having platform engineering teams take ownership of the core functionality of the platform layer and do internal marketing to get all the stakeholders within an organization aligned. It means assigning product management responsibilities that include continuous improvement activities, such as road mapping, usage metric data gathering, and quality monitoring. And also avoiding the common phenomenon, especially in large enterprises, of layering different platform teams that are split by tech stack. Following a platform as a product mindset, the platform built by the platform team competes against other solutions, and customers, the developers, need to experience it as something significantly better than the status quo. So instead of building something on their best guess, for the platform team, everything needs to start with user research. You need to conduct interviews with developers regarding their pain points and figure out what they really need. You have to identify the actions that are performed most often and cause pain, and have a clear user testing and feedback loops in place. Then, based on this user research, come up with a roadmap aligned with your mission statement, not to be confused with a backlog of nice-to-haves. Now, building a platform is one thing, but marketing and selling the platform internally is actually more difficult. To ensure developer adoption, platform teams need to use different kinds of messaging for different kinds of personas. To treat your platform as a product ultimately means to ensure that the platform engineering org creates value by solving organizational problems. You also need to make sure that your platform team is building a product that developers really love. Quick side comment. When evaluating whether to build your own platform following a platform as a product approach, it is also important to consider whether this is the best solution for your team right now. If you don't have the budget to hire a dedicated platform team, for example, it might not be the most feasible option for you at the moment. In such cases, adopting a PaaS, or platform as a service, or an end-to-end platform solution may be more suitable. It is crucial, however, to have an exit plan in place in case you need to transition to a platform as a product later on. As your business grows, you may encounter scalability issues and increased complexity, and the PaaS solution you start using today can often become obsolete in a year from now. This is when shifting to an IDP built with a platform as a product approach can be extremely powerful. Thank you for watching our video on platform engineering and platform as a product. While it's not a one-size-fits-all solution, it is worth exploring to see how it can help you scale and innovate in new ways. If you found this video informative and valuable, please consider subscribing to our channel for more in-depth discussions on platform engineering topics. Thank you for your support and for taking the time to watch, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.